Howdy, this is Lemmy of RevZilla here to talk to you today about the Arlen Ness Monster Sucker Air Intake Kit for Harley. You should be checking out an Arlen Ness Monster Sucker Kit for your bike. If you're trying to make your bike look a little bit different, you're also trying to provide your engine with more air than it could ever possibly use, no matter how much you modify that thing. These are currently coming in a bunch of different flavors for a bunch of different motorcycles. Those of you guys rocking Sportsters, if you're on an Evolution-powered bike, you should be able to find something. And for those of you who are on a big twin, you're gonna see these in production right now for twin cams, as well as for the new Milwaukee 8 engine. Use our bike finder, we're gonna show you the kit that's specific to your year, make, and model, but you should know that if you're on a later model bike, you're probably pretty well covered here. Installation on these is not particularly difficult. I'm going to say this is very similar to other air intakes. If you have experience installing one of those, probably be a one-beater for most of you. If you've never put an air intake on your bike, directions are included with the kit. Very simple. You need basic hand tools. Just about any home mechanic should be able to get one of these onto their bike. Absolutely no sweat. We'll delve into the installation in just a little bit. First things first, though, let's talk about who Arlen Ness is, what he's making, and why this is a very special air cleaner. If you've ridden around on Harleys, if you know anything about Harleys, if you spend any time looking at the magazines, you've probably heard the name Arlen Ness before. This guy is literally the king of choppers. He spawned an entire dynasty of chopper builders. Corey Ness, Zach Ness, his grandson. These guys have been building motorcycles as a family for a really, really long time. Now, also, if you're checking out bike rags, you're looking at other people's bikes, you've probably also seen a super popular Arlen Ness product, the Big Sucker Intake. We sell a gajillion of these things. You'll see them at every single bike night you head out to. Everybody loves the Big Sucker. That being said, it's a standard style air cleaner. It sits flat against the side of your V engine. As folks have seen, styles have changed a little bit. 90-degree style air cleaners like the Monster Sucker have become very popular. Arlen Ness held back, waited a little bit till he did his own version of this, and this is the product. A little bit late relative to some of the other players in the game, but this is a little bit different. So we'll break this thing apart, we'll talk about how this thing's actually constructed and what it's going to do for you. Before we start pulling this thing down though, take a look at the finishes here. You're gonna see these offered in both a chrome and a black. I would kind of point out the black finish, as you can see here, is not strictly black. There are some contrast cut areas on here. So if you're trying to stick with a monochromatic black theme, the black option here may not be the way to go. So to me, the coolest part about these air intake kits are these filters right here. Now, traditionally, Arlen Ness has always stuck a super high flow filter in there. In the old Big Sucker kits, you'd see a K&N high flow filter in there. Awesome filters, last for the life of the bike, it'd be the last air cleaner you ever buy. These things can be cleaned and re-oiled. Things have changed now with the Monster Sucker. This is actually a synthetic material on here. It's no longer a cotton gauze air cleaner. So that means a couple of great things for you. Firstly, there's no more oiling. You don't have to oil this air cleaner anymore. It's kind of just permanently ready to rock and roll. The other thing is, since this is very, very water resistant, most of you are not going to see a need to run a sock. Anybody who has run a high flow air cleaner knows that if it's a very open element, as this thing is, you generally have to run a rain sock over the top of that if you're gonna ride around in wet weather. Your engine obviously cannot digest water. Having the rain sock is kind of a pain. You always had to throw it in a pocket, leave it somewhere on the bike. Now you should not have to do that anymore in most cases, depending on your setup on your motorcycle. The other thing I want you to notice about the air cleaner too is the surface area of this thing. This is a monstrous air cleaner to use for a Harley. Whether it's a sporty or a big twin, there is absolutely no way you are going to need all of the air that this thing can actually flow. So if you're planning on hot rodding your bike, this is a great choice. You don't have to keep replacing your air cleaner. This is one everybody can grow into, regardless of what it is that you're actually going to do to your motorcycle. So we'll get that out of the way, and then we'll move into some of the other stuff here. Next, we'll move on to the backing plate here. It's kind of funny. This thing is not particularly fancy looking. However, this radius right here, you can actually see on the inside here, is actually where this thing is going to help make power. What this is going to do is actually kind of channel and funnel the air into a kind of an orderly fashion as it enters your intake. Believe it or not, there's quite a bit of research in this backing plate. It's an important piece of this setup. Moving on, this is another cool piece that you're also going to, you should appreciate. Even though it kind of looks a little bit clunky junky here, look how small this is. Now, do me a favor, run out to the garage, look at your motorcycle, and look at the air cleaner hanging off the side of your bike. You'll notice that it's absolutely enormous. If you pull the outer cover off and you pull your air cleaner element off, you will also see that the plastic backer there is also quite large, and that's for a couple different reasons. Harley has to meet emissions guidelines, they have to meet noise guidelines, and part of the way they do that is with that very large, voluminous air cleaner. You can can move away from that. You can step into something a little bit more compact. And the way that Arlen Ness is able to do this is not just by scaling down the backing plate, but also by incorporating these breathers here. So if you're looking again at your stock air cleaner housing, you're gonna notice those two ugly tubes that kind of come off the heads and squirt into the air cleaner housing there. Now what Arlen Ness does is incorporates this right into the head mounts themselves. You don't have any exposed breather tubes. Your breathers are actually hidden now. It's a very slick system. Really does make things a little bit more compact, a little tighter. It's a very simple and beautiful solution to the problem. So let's talk installation for just a moment. That'll kind of round out the last things you're going to see up here in the box. Installation on these is made easy, firstly, because Arlen Ness includes everything you need in the box. You'll notice the hardware here. You'll notice all the gaskets you need, your breather banjo bolts. Everything's right there in the box. If you have the box in front of you and you start ripping your bike apart, you've got everything you need in terms of parts in order to get this thing onto your motorcycle. Now, that's not a very difficult process. If you've changed your own air cleaner element before, you're pretty much 50% of the way through the job. You just have to pop off the backing plate as well in order to install one of these. You're gonna need basic hand tools. You're looking at your ratchets, your wrenches, maybe a screwdriver or two, but nothing here is gonna be very difficult. You shouldn't need a bunch of tools or a bunch of know-how in order to do this. Arlen Ness does include instructions with these things. They're very good instructions. You'll see some pictures in there. You should get through this without much work at all. Now, when it comes right down to it, I gotta be honest, a 90 degree air cleaner, maybe not necessarily exactly my style. However, from a performance aspect, this is definitely the way to go. These things are gonna flow a ton of air. If you like the look, you can be sure this is a quality product that you're gonna be very pleased with after you bolt that thing onto your bike. Don't take my word for it, however, click that info button, check out what some riders who are rocking a monster sucker on their bike think about it. If you need a little bit more information as far as installation instructions or perhaps fitment guidance, don't hesitate to get in touch with one of our gear geeks, 877-792-9455. Of course, you can always get us by email as well, cs@revzilla.com. I'm Lemmy, I'm out of here.